Mo asks, would I write my notes the same for MCAT as I do for my classes? And the answer to that, Mo, is no, I would not. And yes, I would. And no, I would not. And the reason I say that is because when we talk about the MCAT,
but stop making excuses, stop whining, stop, right? Get at it. No excuses, just dominate.
So classes versus the MCAT. Classes, this is a short study interval. This is long. This is content based. This is application and test skill based. This is confined, right? So it's a singular subject. This is complex, multi-subject. They're different. I teach my students, whether it's for classes or for MCAT, we take notes in general. We have the same system. The way we approach reading, note-taking, test-taking is the same. But when it comes to the MCAT, the slight tweak you're gonna make is that because with MCATing, here we're gonna be a lot of, because it's content, it's a lot of content-based stuff. On the MCAT, it's application and test skill, so we wanna do lots of questions. The reason your note-taking has to be different for the MCAT is because with the MCAT, you should be, if you're studying correctly, doing lots of questions. And if you're doing lots of questions, the best way to do that is that you do mixed question sets, meaning one day or one session, you're studying one subject, another day, another subject, studying a different subject. So you're bouncing around a lot of different places. The mistake I see students make with their MCAT notes is they make non-linear, non-organized notes. So let me erase this. I bring this up because what a lot of students use is what's called the missed questions list. A lot of different names for this, but they have a whole list or a whole file, whatever, of missed questions. They also have, right, a list of topics that they've covered. And so they have essentially two sets of notes. The first principle of note-taking is that we want our notes to be clear, concise, clear and concise. If we have two sets, our notes are not going to be concise and they're also going to be muddled by two different sets. So the first thing I want to say is that you should have one single set of MCAT notes. The second flip side of that is with these notes, we don't want to make them in random mixed order. So today I did this subject and it's followed by this subject. I'm just writing things down because it will be a mixed bag of random things. The way that our brain learns and holds on to things, I just said, for the MCAT, we're studying for a long period of time, we have to hold information for a long time. We have to create functional constructs and infrastructure for our learning. So if you think about it this way, when we learn, we want to have a nice framework where we can hang topic number one, topic number two, topic number three, topic number four, and so that we can see how they're all interconnected. So we have a sound structure to hang all the little details, all the little subtext, all the whatever on. If we take notes randomly, this is this. When we go through those notes, we are going to be jumping all over the map with no logical construct to bring that knowledge and consolidate things together, to unify them. Did I lose people? Does that make sense? Comment right now. Does this make sense what I'm talking about? We need to have a construct, an infrastructure. So we want to have one set of notes, and we want those notes to be organized. So when you have a note stack, whether it's electronic or it's a paper notebook, if you hit one topic on Monday, let's say you hit cell membranes and action potentials on Monday. Then you do a bunch of stuff, blah, 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 and then you get another question about cell membranes on Wednesday. The rookie way, and what most people do, is that they make Monday might be here, and then Wednesday might be way over here on a whole other page. What I want you guys to do is to make an organized note set. So if Monday I hit cell membrane, even though I'm all the way down here, if I hit cell membrane again, I want to say, no, I'm not taking a new note. I want to go back and I want to concretize, I want to clarify my previous note on cell membranes. So I want to go back and say, okay, what new thing did I learn about cell membranes? What improved perspective do I have now of cell membranes that I can jot down to make this note clearer and more concise and more effectual and applicable for my MCAT test date, as opposed to just making these notes longer and longer and longer and impossible to A, go through, and B, to build functional knowledge because things aren't tied together. But if we do this and we go back and we add everything about cell membranes there and everything about glycolysis here and so forth, it creates this infrastructure for us to say, oh, this is how it's related. This is not related. It's a natural progression of the information. Yes? Does that answer the question? If you have questions, put them in the box, y'all. If I'm hitting it on the head, like this video right now. Let the YouTube algorithm know that Dr. Pinesett's bringing it.
That's it for another episode of the Study Doc Show. Show your love by smashing the like button and commenting in the box below. Today is the day, guys. No more excuses, no more complaining. You're going to take your future into your own hands. You're going to dominate. You're going to be successful. I challenge you. What are you going to do today to make your life better? Get to my website, thestudydoc.com. Grab a free ebook. Sign up for a free webinar. And if you're really ready to transform, enroll in one of my life-changing courses or coaching programs. You have greatness inside you. Let me show you how to unlock it so you can dominate and make your dreams a reality. No excuses, just dominate.